doesn't matter what the activity is. If the person wants to do it, we should be able to find a way to make it happen. But a lot of times those devices don't exist on the shelf and we literally have to create it.
I'd say probably half of my life has revolved around volleyball in one way or another. The ability to play at that level, to be able to hit balls that hard, to be able to pass, to be able to run, jump, and do all that stuff, to be able to win the game is really what drives me.
This prosthesis that we have for Ramon is specifically for golf. It's called an activity-specific golf prosthesis. This is why we have this special wrist unit that we have for him, the Rover wrist. And Ramon himself has helped with developing a terminal device.
Maybe after the third, fourth try, we came up with this, and this hasn't failed me since.
Activity-specific prosthetics are something that we provide much more often than other companies do.
I have a body-powered socket. It has a ton of different attachments. I think I have like 6 or 7 different ones for just different things. I actually have 2 for weightlifting, 1 for riding a bike, and yeah, pretty much everything for it.
A rock climbing prosthesis, a swimming prosthesis, a golf prosthesis, all of those activities are extremely important to the patient, so I want to be able to give them the best ability to do it.
The lacrosse prosthetic got me a long way with lacrosse. It even got me recruited to come play at University of Utah, play lacrosse there. They will do anything I ask them. If I have any ideas, something I want to do, they will do anything to get to that point.
I would have to say that if you as an upper extremity amputee are not as involved in the design and construction process of your prosthetic as possible, then you are seriously limiting your activities and what you can and can't do, especially if it's an activity-specific prosthetic.
I love that feeling of delivering that device to somebody and just watching them be able to get back into those sporting activities or other recreational activities that they weren't able to do because of injury.
I have a terminal device and a different arm that, you know, it's kind of a one-size-fits-all device that I can grab onto the bars, I can pull, I can do anything I have to do with it.
We want to make sure that we provide the best product we can for the patient and make sure that they can do the activities that they want to do, that they accomplish those dreams and goals with the devices we can make for them.
You have to be proactive in anything you do. And when it comes to prosthetics, it's probably even more so. Something I like to say to people, I said, there's life after injury. It's up to you what that life is going to be.